Hello everyone, welcome to Abhipedia, powered by Abhimanyu IAS. This is 17th lecture of Science and Tech Value Addition Series with Dr. Vivek Rana. We have been covering themes and topics which are important from UPSC Prelims 2020 point of view. And today's lecture is an interesting one. It's an interdisciplinary lecture covering two modules of Science and Tech. There's robotics on one hand and space on another. So if you are following the newspapers regularly or some social media websites, this topic should not come as a surprise for you, because it's likely to dominate headlines for this week as well as in future as well. So topic for today's lecture is the humanoids in space, and we'll be covering the all important humanoids which have been making news so far. And this topic lecture is divided into three parts. First, I will discuss the Indian one, which is making the headlines, Vyom Mitra. Then I will cover the historical journey of humanoids which have been into space successfully. And finally, a practice question on the theme. So without wasting any time, let's start what this Vyom Mitra is all about. Now, first of all, before starting this humanoid theme, let's discuss what humanoid is. Humanoid is a term which is used to describe robots which have a superficial resemblance to human beings. Such robots generally have a head, two arms and two legs. So if you could see in your screen, the Vyom Mitra has a head and two arms, but legs are missing. So this robot has been classified as half humanoid. And the meaning of this Vyom Mitra is, Vyom in Sanskrit means for space, and Mitra is friend. So this, you have to understand, is an assistant which is being sent in space mission, and in original Gaganyaan mission, which is slated for 2022, it will be accompanying the crew module team and is likely to support them. Now, the likely theme on which UPSC can confuse you is difference between Vyom Naut and Vyom Mitra. Vyom Naut, you have to understand, is name for the astronauts which are being sent into space. Vyom Mitra is the half humanoid. So already Indian Air Force, four members from Indian Air Force have been shortlisted to be sent into space, and they have been trained, will be trained in Russia. And since there is no woman in the original team, so this humanoid has been created with the woman features, and it's been called Vyom Mitra. So what it is likely to do in this Gaganyaan mission or in the test missions, it can communicate in two languages. So it's a talkative humanoid robot, and it can provide life support systems which if when required. And thirdly, the standard switch panel operations it is likely to carry out successfully. So it will likely to be an assistant which will provide them support. And this is what Vyom Mitra is all about. Because already Gaganyaan mission we had covered in our earlier lectures of the Science and Tech Value Addition series. In case you have missed, just go through it. I have discussed what Gaganyaan mission is, what are the likely objectives, what are the key technologies involved in the mission, because that mission can be associated with this theme and a better question can be framed. Gaganyaan is likely to catapult India into that space power journey, and India is likely to be the fourth nation to send humans in space, because so far only US, Russia and China have sent their missions, and eventually this is a follow-up journey to International Space Station missions. So make sure whatever news comes regarding this Vyom Mitra or Vyom Nauts or Gaganyaan, to be more specific, you must follow it. Because before earlier we used to send the living species like dogs, Laika is the example, which was sent into space before humans were sent into space. But currently, instead of human beings or dog or living species, we are sending humanoids as a test in testing phase. So in demonstration phase, which is likely to be carried out in December 2020 itself, and in 2021, this Vyom Mitra would be sent in space mission, and eventually in Gaganyaan mission, this mission is likely to be a follow-up. Now let's discuss what humanoids have already been successfully into space missions, because whenever such themes are in news, generally historical context also gets activated. Because it's not that India is the pioneer in sending humanoids in space. Already three space powers have sent their humanoids, and results have been a promising one. So the one which you are seeing on your screen is Robonaut. It already has two versions, R1 and R2. And the one which you are seeing on your screen is R2. Now this Robonaut 2 was sent in space in 2011. And as you can see, it has a head, two arms and two legs. So it's a proper humanoid, unlike the one which we had discussed in Vyomitra, which was classified as half humanoid. So it was sent in space the National Space Station mission, it provided assisting role and performed plethora of functions which were assigned to it. And this mission has been progressing, and the new version is likely to be out soon. So NASA and US space agencies have been pioneered once again in sending humanoids in space. Coming to the next example, it's Kirobo. Kirobo, you can see, is quite a small prototype of humanoids, and this is just 33 centimeter in height and has weight of just 1 kg. Why these humanoids are created lightweight? Because already the payloads are quite heavy. When you are sending a crew module, human beings article, then their weight already adds excessive pressure in the launch pad space shuttle. So generally the assisting robots are made of lightweight. And this Kirobo in Japanese language means hope. So this was the Japanese robot which can talk. It's once again a talkative one. It can talk in Japanese language, and it has a unique distinction of being in Guinness Book of World Record, because it has spent 18 months in International Space Station, and it was sent with a astronaut. The name was Koichi Wagata, and this makes it quite special that it was able to communicate with it. And it has a distinction of being talkative robot at the highest ever altitude since it was in International Space Station. So this mission set the tone that we can send such talkative humanoids in robot, and our Vyomitra is a improved version of this Kirobo, because it can converse in two languages. Kirobo could talk just in Japanese language. And the final example in today's lecture is FADER. FADER has made headlines in 2019 itself. In August, it was sent in the International Space Station mission. And this mission was of Russia. And this word FADER is an acronym. So once again, I'll be highlighting what this FADER is. FADER is Final Experiment Demonstration Object Research. So this robot was created for rescue operations, but eventually it was sent into space. And the main thing which they were trying to achieve was a spacewalk. And unfortunately, within 10 days, this mission couldn't deliver the expected results. And the mission has completed its timeline. It's no longer functional. But still, it's a learning process, because the legs were quite long. They didn't meet the expectation of a spacewalk. So eventually, Russia is going to improve the design, and in future going to send such missions. So this is all our learning examples that how these humanoid, because eventually it's always better to send machines in outer space mission due to risk involved. We all know that Columbia mission, in which we lost our own Dr. Kalpana Chawla. So these humanoids are likely to become more and more frequent in International Space Station missions. Already over 500 space flights have been taken place, and now it's the time that machines or humanoids are doing the job for humans. And these are all demonstration projects which set the ground for manned missions. So this is what I have for today's lecture. Now, like we always do, a practice question, and once again I have picked the robots which are related to artificial intelligence as well, and which have been making headlines in last 2 or 3 years, because robotics is one theme in which mains question have been asked in UPSC, and even though it's mentioned in the syllabus, prelims question is yet to appear in last 5 years. So since this time Vyomitra is in news and this FADER has been in news, so there is a probability they might ask one or two robots if they have. So once again, I have picked the best ones for practice, and you have to choose the incorrectly matched pair out of the given four. All four are important. If you have to quote them in mains, they are the almost ideal example. Da Vinci. Now Da Vinci, as the name suggests, some of you might get confused that it could be a painting robot or something to do with restoring ancient heritage site. But no, this Da Vinci robot is used in robotic assisted surgery. It's already used in AIIMS, PGI and in other private hospitals as well. So this is not a misnomer, because Da Vinci has done extensive research as well as work on human anatomy. That's why his pictures or paintings are of lifelike images. So this first one is correctly mapped, it's used in surgery. Then FADR, we had just discussed, is used for space only, and it was sent International Space Station mission in August 2019 itself. So that's also a correct match. Now ROS is an interesting example, because this is one area in which robotics had artificial intelligence had not penetrated yet, but in 2018-19 phase it has finally entered. Yes, the ROS is related to legal research. It is touted as world's first artificial intelligent lawyer. And due to overburdened judiciary, I think it makes a lot of sense to use more and more such expert systems in decision making. And this is once again a correct option. So finally, the fourth one, Bandicoot. This, you have to understand, is related to a plaguing theme which has been a bane for Indian society, manual scavenging. Because this manual scavenging involves a lot of risk. Some precious lives have already been lost this in 2019 itself as well. So it was suggested that manual scavenging should be dealt with the machine part, robotics part, and this is one of the prohibitive labor which can be sustainably managed by robotics. So finally, we are more and more states are switching to Bandicoot. So this is a quite important example. These Bandicoots are eventually a mammal type species on which it has been named, and they are quite active in such scavenging role. So this is the ideal name which has been placed. So incorrectly matched pair is the D. So I hope this session was useful. I'll be back soon with another science and tech value addition lecture. Till then, keep practicing hard and keep following the various series which are ongoing. Thank you very much.